Oh, what a wonderful Sunday that was.
Shall we wait a minute or shall we leave the truck in? Welcome to the Roadless Traveler Podcast, the video. I'm Sean Tretheway, your host. Okay.
Hey, clean that sidewalk.
It's such a loud truck, though.
With the motherfucking truck.
He's cleaning the sidewalk. I used to collect the brushes from those trucks. I used to find these metal things, and I collected them for such a long time, thinking, where are they coming from? They were always in the gutter, always found one or two at a time. It's metal sticks, and I had a jar full of them. I'd always pick them up, take them home, add them. One day I finally realized it's from those brushes.
I thought you'd say, one day I finally got enough to make a whole truck.
Yeah. Yeah. So I threw them away. When I found out the mystery was lost, that I just tossed them out.
Pipe cleaners.
They were useless.
They weren't good for brushing stuff.
Anyway, we had a really great day. A week ago?
It was a week ago. What a week it's been.
Wow. We had a lot of fun. We went to Wallaby Heights, home of Barry and Diana Charles, where they have a little shed and they hold some house concerts occasionally. And we performed the first performance of...
Is Diana's surname Charles?
I don't know.
It'd be funny, hey, Charles, Diana, or what?
I never thought of that.
Yeah,
Charles, Diana.
Lady Di, that's what I call her.
Lady Di. She is a lady.
She's a lady.
She's a lady. Anyway, so we did the first performance. We performed the first time as a foursome, Magic Music and Mayhem, along with Carl Lynch, myself, Harii Bandhu, and of course the amazing Mark Moroney.
Or Macca, yes,
or
friend
Macaroni,
of the stars,
as you like to call him.
Macaroni man.
Mm.
He's friends with all the. The big knobs
he
in
does,
the industry.
He does have a lot of friends in high places, doesn't
Urban,
he?
Barnes, Moroney man.
Percival.
We did, and Sean sang very nicely. We've just in here
Thank
in
you.
Secret Labs doing some bit of editing. And we thought, why not have a little a prelude.
Prelude.
A prelude of light.
So, not a lot to say about it, except that Carl did a marvelous job putting this video together. So, thank you very much, Carl.
I think you can say putting up the fairy lights. Carl did a marvelous job with that.
Thank you, Sean. There were fairy lights.
No, they weren't.
Where?
Carl did a wonderful job that night. He made a wonderful cup of tea for everyone.
He did. Lovely cup of tea. But seriously...
But seriously, folks.
I was a little bit nervous on the night. I got one of the lyrics wrong. Sorry, Macca. I really didn't do that on purpose, just so you know.
Yes, now it'll be kept for posterity.
Yeah.
Not prosperity.
No.
Here comes that friggin' truck that you put together when you were a kid.
Why don't we watch the show now, Carl?
Let's watch the show.
Okay. Here we go with the very first Roadless Traveler Podcast video. Enjoy.
Hello there. Hello, hello, hello. 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 Yeah. Very good. And yes, special treat today, the Coolum Throat Singers.
Now, Throat Singer.
Keep the name as...
Very throatish.
Deep Throat, yes.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my
God. Oh, somebody.
You knew Linda Lovelace.
Who said that? Look, our next great act for today is full of magic, music, what are they going to say, mayhem. And
Carl's the mayhem.
Carl's
why,
mayhem.
Why am I always pointed out as being the most
mayhem?
Yes,
MMM. Is not those ones in the packet? MMM. Magic, music, and mayhem. And you'll be truly obliterated by their creative energy.
In a good way.
That's the best I can come up with. Okay, what about a bigger hand for Harii, Carl, Mark and Shauno? The first big appearances on the Sunshine Coast, exclusive to Wallaby Heights.
Shondo, the Noosa Magician.
Woo!
Hi, everyone. I'm Sean. I'm your magician tonight. I'm the magic part. I've known these three guys for quite a long time now, and you are so lucky to have, like, some of the greatest talent on the Sunshine Coast, possibly in Australia, right here playing together tonight, which is really awesome. And I'm lucky enough to have the best seat in the house, so there you go. Now, I just want to mention that I've had each of these guys, including Barry and a few other people here on my podcast, the Roadless Traveler Podcast, so I'm going to put in a quick plug. If you want to hear some more about these guys, trtpod.com. It's an interview series with music mixed in, and I think you'll really enjoy it. That's all I'm going to say about that. Now, before I get started, I just want to... I brought something with... Sorry, just one second. I should have set this up ahead of time. I like to collect articles the old school way, not the cut and paste way, but...
That's not it. Just the cut.
Just the cut, yeah. The cut and... Wait a minute. No, I've got it here. Got it right. Where is it? Sure. Yeah, that's not it. Yeah. Okay, look. Maybe I should have set this up a little bit better. Oh. I'll tell you what, I'll just do it the magic way. There we go. That's better. Thank you. Wait a minute. So that's the magic way to do whatever it is. Uh-oh. Hello. Okay, well, it was pretty close, wasn't it? What's... Oh, I forgot one. I missed one. Doggone it. Hate it when that happens. That would have been a good trick, eh? Wait a minute. Grab it. Thank you, Mark. That would have been a good trick, eh?
Yeah.
Tell you what, I'll just pop that in like that, and nobody will know the difference. Just get in there. Perfect, right? Well, it looks good from this side, doesn't it? Yeah?
Yes.
And it looks pretty good from this side, too. There you go. Okay, thank you. So, we've got quite a show for you tonight. We had a real fun rehearsal just the other day down at the Secret Laboratory. And we've got some beautiful songs written by these terrific artists. As I said, the first one we're going to have is from Mr. Mecca, and that is Chasing Waterfalls. Chasing Fairy Tales.
TLC.
Give it up!
When I'm by myself, just being no one else, my mind is in full bloom. Traveling and far, I don't need a fancy car. Long as I got my guitar, I'll be smiling till the end. And here I go again, chasing fairy tales. I'm so happy when my mind goes off the rails. Music to my ears when inspiration flows. I leave everything behind and go. Sometimes I can be shy, and and I'm known to be a bore. My social skills are poor the best of times, but when you find a thing that makes you smile and makes you sing, you drop everything, and before you know, you might find yourself chasing fairy tales. I'm so happy when my mind goes off the rails. Music to my ears when inspiration flows. I leave everything behind and go. Oh, 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 oh. I'll leave everything. I don't mean to be rude, but sometimes I tend to lose my mind in mid conversations. It's something that I do. Understand that it's not you, it's just my imagination. Just my imagination. So here I find myself chasing fairy tales. And I'm so happy when my mind goes off the rails. Music to my ears when inspiration flows. I leave everything behind and go. Oh, oh, let's leave everything behind.
They're very good.
Thanks, mate.
These guys are so good the way they play together, aren't they? Next up, we're going to have Harii do one of his numbers. Harii, do you want to say anything about this?
He doesn't know which song it is.
Yeah, tell me what song
it is. He just asked me, what am I doing?
It's honorable man. So honorable man, I think we should hear from man. Now.
Yeah, it's been a full-on week, guys.
Oh, shit, you're up.
Oh. That's why we got bald heads, so we can see the dents.
Well, we were called the Badgers for a while, but Sean's got hair, so we're no longer the Badgers.
And I forgot to bring my clippers.
What?
I'm not going to say anything. This is called Honourable Man, so you guys can figure it out. If I'm an honorable man, I will walk my talk and live my life in the spirit of connection. If I'm an honorable man, I will be my truth, not be my love in this isle of sexual ocean. If I'm an honorable man, I will rise above my loneliness, love myself in my evolution. If I'm an honorable man, I will right or wrong, see my path, keep my resolution. Shuns on never one. Ever heard beautiful person like you? The devil will ever cheap on such a love. Gave so true, such a love now. It gave so true. All and all, we can don't sing songs in my words and lies. If your spirit dies and the air you breathe is the air I see, how can you argue live if I never, never, never gave my fidelity, fidelity, fidelity. Only your grace, all the beautiful, wonderful things all you say. Only your love, only your grace, all the beautiful, wonderful things all you say. If I'm an honorable man, I will let you go to hear your soul. Never ask for resurrection. I'm an honorable man, I will thank the gods for the path of love, and you're giving me your total devotion. And I heard a beautiful person like you, and I never will ever keep on hunting out. Oh, you know such a love, so true. Oh, Macca, give me something, give me something now. Songs in my words are lies. If your spirit dies in the air you breathe is the air I see, how can you live if I never, 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 never give my fidelity, only your love, only your grace, all the beautiful, wonderful things that you say. Only your love, only your grace, beautiful, wonderful things that you say.
Bandhu.
Harii.
Harii.
Harii. Harii.
Harii.
Hey, you'll get Krishna dancing on your tongue if you say that name.
You might,
really? Yes. Don't you know that?
Wait, why don't you explain it to us, Carl?
Well, I know he wears obnail boots. So.
Krishna does? Oh, okay. All
when
right.
He dances on your tongue. That's what it feels like when I eat certain Hare Krishna food. I like it too. I love hobnail boots on my tongue. So for me, it's a good thing.
I think you want to talk to this guy after the show.
Oh, yeah. Now, what's all that about?
Who is that, Barry?
This is our security. This is our security today.
Security.
Right. So anybody who messes with it, anybody has to talk to him. Oh, by the way, you may notice that I'm filming some stuff up here. We're filming everything today, and we're going to record it as well. It's going to be a podcast to listen to again later and show to all your friends. And Carl's going to cut it all together into a little movie as well, so if it works out. So if anybody out there happens to take any film at any point in the movie and they want to send it on to...
Hang on, I might do that right now.
Yeah, good idea. Why don't you do that? And send it to Barry, and then Carl will get it and put it all together in this fabulous movie. It's going to be amazing.
He's got like the editing. Hey,
yeah, like that.
Why is it all blurry?
Yeah. Probably you don't have your glasses on.
It's focusing on something. It's the moon.
I don't know what you're filming. I'm done talking now.
It's a close-up.
The moon.
Nice.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
There's two other moons here, too.
Triple moon.
Triple moon.
Yeah.
What planet is that?
I don't know, but I'm sure it's something about...
Oh, well, I think that deserves
that.
An oh.
Well,
what
are you too early for that, oh. Carl? Jesus.
Well, if you didn't laugh.
Yeah. So right. You're going to do a little number for us, Cal?
Hey, it's podcast. If I was putting on an American accent, where would I be from? Hey, it's a podcast. Is it?
Yeah, probably Canada.
All right, that's the end of yeah. The banter.
Yeah.
Such a long, long time ago, I left my mother's home and I started out into the great unknown. Soon enough, I found my place was not here with the human race, but far away past Alpha Centauri. You see, I got no reason why in space I couldn't fly, and she's a joy in my eyes today. Come on, nothing new under the sun, so I'm gonna find another one and I'll pick you up on my way somehow. And wherever that spaceship lands, I'll be on it, got no plans to stay. I'm light years away. Light years away. I'm light years away.
Who's your dad?
Thank you.
came from me while I was asleep. It's how they get you while you dream. It took me and took me up on high, so high. So when you look up at a starry sky, I think of why not instead of I. But that's all you need to know. Well, I got no reason why in space I couldn't fly. And sees the joy in my eyes today. There's nothing new under the sun, so I'm gonna find another one. I'll pick you up on my way somehow. I'll be on it, got no place to stay. I'll be light years away. I'm light years away. I'm light.
Lynch.
Thank you kindly, friends. Yeah. Appreciate that. Where would I be in the United States if I talk like that? Hmm?
Uh-huh.
I don't know. Wagga wagga.
Your Oh, okay. How about a little more magic?
Yeah.
Yay.
Can y'all see me okay? A bit. Oh, that's better.
They got legs that they can.
So that's a little chaser for you, Sean.
Thank you. Thank you, chaser. By request, it was asked of me to do this next little piece that I like to do. It's actually an explanation of how magic is created, how illusions are created. And I'm going to show you one of the main principles of magic, and that principle is that the hand is quicker than the eye. You've all heard that before, the hand is quicker than the eye. I'm going to show you exactly how that works. Now, during this demonstration, I'm going to break three of the main rules of magic. The first one is I'm going to explain what I'm going to do before I do it. Second one is I'm going to repeat the trick twice, something most magicians never do. And the third one is, this is the most important one of all, I'm going to tell you how I do it. Okay, are you ready? I know, it's against the rules. You all have to keep it a secret, otherwise I'll have my magic wand broken, and that hurts. Now, this is a little illusion involving a red silk hanky. Nothing to say, Carl? Okay. This is a little illusion with a little red silk hanky. The important thing is you keep your eye on the silk and its location. It starts off in my left hand. The left hand is one with the silk. That's the one to keep an eye on. It will travel invisibly through the air and into my pocket over here. But because I'm going to do it faster than you can see it happen, you won't see it happen. You ready? That quick. See? It's gone. And it has, in fact, traveled right over here into this pocket. I see you're speechless with amazement. Now, for the second phase, I'm going to do it twice. This makes it even harder for me because now you know what to watch for, so you'll be watching twice as closely. Now, remember, the silk starts in the left hand, and that is the one that you have to keep your eye on. Keep your eye on the left hand. That's the one with the silk. It's going to travel through the air and into my pocket. I haven't done it yet. Yeah, you knew that. All right, here we go. I was just making sure you were watching. The silk goes into my left hand. Left hand has the silk. That's the one with the silk. Travels through the air. It's not over here. In fact, it's already disappeared from that hand. It didn't go to that pocket. This time, it went right back to the pocket where it started. Thank you. Thank you. Ah, thank you. My mother used to tell me this would be a much better trick if I would open my other hand, but then you'd see the egg. Thank you. Now, as promised, I am going to show you how this trick is done, but you really have to promise not to tell anybody because it's a secret. So the secret is that that is not the silk I started off with. That is a second silk, a duplicate, and that was in my pocket the whole time. The original silk is inside the egg. There you go. That egg was in this pocket over here. Now, the reason why I let you see me put the silk in the first time was so that when I pretended to put it into my pocket the second time, I could grab out the egg without arousing your suspicion. And then I showed you that it was actually over here. I swapped the egg to my left hand, pushed the silk down into the egg. And by the way, the hardest part of this trick is finding hens that lay eggs with holes in them. But if you can, you too can be a magician. So I pushed the silk down into the egg, and then I pulled the second silk out of my pocket and revealed the egg. And it's a pretty cute little trick, don't you think? Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. So that's how the hand is quicker than the eye. But it's not really magic, of course. Because if it was real magic, would you hand me that glass, please, Mecca? It would have to be a real egg. A real messy egg. Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah. Wow. Nice. Clean up on stage three.
Have a wiffle ball.
Mop and bucket required.
Mop and bucket there required. Something.
All right.
Aisle three. Clean up in aisle three, please.
Next up is a little song from one of our favorite bands, The Band.
The Band.
Oh, yeah, The Band. Oh, yeah, that
the
band.
I've heard of The Band.
The Band.
The Band.
That band.
That band.
Are you right
with
that? The.
If you'd like to join in on this next song, everybody, please don't. It really throws us off. I don't know what's going on. Eggs remind me of a joke, but it's I think we've covered that joke here.
Picked up my bag, went looking for a place to hide. When I saw Carmen and the devil walking side by side, I said, hey Carmen, what about don't go downtown? She said, I got to go, but my friend, she can stick around. Take a load off Fanny. Take a load for free. Take a load off Fanny.
Yeah. Put the load
right on me. gonna say is just on a loop, and Luke's been raining on a judgment day. Luke, my friend, what about young Anna, Anna Lee? Said, do me a favor, son, won't you stay and keep Anna Lee company? Hey.
Take a load off Annie, take a load free. Take a load off Annie.
To follow me, he caught me in the fog. He said, I'll fix your rags if you will take my dog. I said, wait a minute, Chester, you know why I'm a peaceful man. He said, that's okay, boy, won't you feed him when you can.
Take a load off Annie, take a load free, take a load off Annie.
Put the load,
put the load right on me.
Brother Macca, macaroni one time. Close enough, it'll do. It's live after all, live podcast.
We were on YouTube for ages. Well, I was.
Okay, so now we're going to hear another song from Mr. Macca. Mr. Macca, whose parents are here tonight, and it was their 50th anniversary yesterday. Huh? Let's hear it for them.
Stand up, Mama Dad. Come on. Happy come on, there they are. Come on, stand up.
Happy anniversary.
Hey, hey,
happy anniversary. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary. Happy anniversary. That was a Flintstone.
Love you guys. A song called This Dream.
On Macaroni.
Thank you. Wow.
What a beautiful tasty song. That's one of Macca's latest singles. Where can they get that? Yeah. Do they still get that online?
In the frozen aisle.
You can get it for free online, actually.
Oh,
jump on
free.
My website. Free
oh,
download.
Free.
Jump on the mailing list.
Wow.
Yeah, we've all got CDs and EPs here tonight too.
Yes,
so
that's
right. So if you dig in the tunes.
Well, we don't all have CDs and EPs.
Oh, what have you got?
I've got books
with holes in them.
I've got two books.
Sean's got some books.
You got words.
Yeah, I've got newspaper with holes in them. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. Yes, I have the books, The Roadless Traveler and Beyond the Road. Soon to come, The Road to the Heart. Keep an eye out for that one. Great. All right. We're going to move along.
Are we going to have a break in a minute?
In a minute.
And we're going to mingle with everyone.
We've actually got two more songs, unless you want to take a break now. Carl,
what's the next
tired?
Song on the list? I'm not quite
G
sure.
G Baby. It's actually Harii's song, G Baby.
Oh, wow.
Which I think we should do now, personally.
That's a jazzy little number.
Love makes me treat you the way that I do. Gee, baby, ain't I good to you? Nothing almost good, yeah. But a girl, that's so true. Gee, baby, I'm good to you. Baby, I bought you a fur coat for Christmas. Honey, now you know a diamond ring, a Cadillac, a car, and everything. Oh, love. Honey, mama, love. Baby, treat you nice. You know the way that I do. GB, baby, ain't I good to you? Love.
but that make me treat you now, you know, the way that I do. GB, baby, ain't I good to you? Oh, GB, baby, ain't I good to you? Ain't I? Oh, ooh, ooh. Good to you. About that thing. Oh.
You know he's good to you. Woo! He's so good to you, baby.
Woo! Okay. Well, we've got one more song, or we could take a break now if you want, Barry. You're on the move.
Oh, shit, here comes the
boss. Jumping up.
Oh, there we go.
Security. Oh, no, security.
Barry.
Get him.
Oh, I got him in polished shoes. Well,
we're going to play more. We're going
to
play
more. You
need
to go to the mango tree. It's out the back, fellas. Out the mango tree.
It's next to the hot chili bush.
We've got more. You guys want to do one more?
Don't get them wrong. Don't get it. Otherwise,
you want to take a break and then come back?
No,
we're all. We'll do one more, mate.
We'll do one more.
I think we should stick to our tightly rehearsed schedule.
Let's go. Yeah.
Another song.
Right. Okay.
We can't go off script.
We'll get way too confused, really.
Yeah, we don't know what will happen. Everything's carefully constructed like a...
And it's written down. On a piece of paper.
It is wrote, actually.
Yeah. It is wrote in stone. Yes, that is correct.
By the finger of someone up there in the sky.
Hobnail boots.
It's like two tablets, except there's four tablets that we all should take to be normal.
I'll drink to that.
Does anyone like the blues? Well, I've got a great heritage of the blues in my blood from the cotton pickers of Wagga Wagga. And I was different from the other children down there in Wagga. They called me Snowflake and I was ostracized. It's true. So I think I can relate a little bit to this next one. All right, let's go ahead and just play the thing then. Bad.
crawl. It wasn't for bad luck, but I wouldn't have no luck at all. I can hardly write. My whole life has been one big fight. Thank you.
bam, 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 born to be alive.
We are born to be alive, and I'm glad we're all alive together.
Well, well, give him a break. What about a big hand? The magic, mayhem, and music. The Sunshine Coast's newest and greatest act. Yeah, thanks, guys. It's always a joy.
Having music here. Whoops, sorry.
So you've been cut off, Barry.
It's all right. He thinks I'm a politician.
Sorry.
But they'll be back. They're going to have a 15-minute break, and we'll just have a chat and catch up on local gossip and anything else you can find in your pocket. Thank you.
I wonder what Barry did end up finding in his pocket. Could have been an appendage of some type, wouldn't it? That was a good set, huh? That was our first one together.
It was very good. And so for part two, click on the banner.
Don't banner, let her in.
No, wait a minute. Because part two is not going to be up till in a week from now.
Don't click on the link that's not there.
Yeah, but next week, part two will be up. And then if you're watching this, then there will be a link here for part two.
Will appear, as if by...
magic.
Wandering.
Mayhem.